So heat transfer in a thin film, that we are discussing. So here the hot gases, they are coming from the heat source. So you can see that the thin fins are attached to the base. So here conduction is occurring. So you can see that heat is coming in this direction. And we are making here that one small elemental strip we are taking. So that this will, if you study this, will this small elemental strip, and if you add this n number of small elemental strip over the over this length, so you are going to get the overall heat transfer in the fins or the extended surface, and then heat dissipation you need to calculate. So here one more diagram you are seeing here. So this diagram is the convection. So from the heated body, so the convection is occurring over a length. So heat is transferring in this direction, and you can see that width as well as the thickness of the rectangular fins. So the figure shows that the typical element from the rectangular fin arrangement and conductivity convection heat transfer mechanism. So as I mentioned, the one of the key factor here that we need to increase the heat dissipation, right? So then only we can understand or we can reduce the thermal stresses associated with it. So here you can see that in order to increase the heat dissipation from the convection from a given primary surface, additional surface may be added. The additional material added is referred to either an extended surface or a fin. A familiar example is motorcycle. So as I have given the example of you can see the automotive or motorcycles. So Royal Enfield and Splendor, you can see. So motorcycle in which fins extending from the outer surface of the engine to dissipate more heat by convection. So this is the example. So next we'll see the formulation. So how this particular the heat transfer problem is, we are going to make an FEM model. So FE formulation. So here what we are doing is described as the given fin using suitable element type. So we are need to know about what type of discretization process we need to take and what type of element we need to take. Remember that when you're solving in ANSYS, when you are preferring the problem definition, when you are preferring the structure related problem, you are going to select the structure related elements. So something like bricks, you are if you are taking, then it is related to the structural. Then same time when you are relating to the fluid mechanics problem or aerodynamics problem, already we studied. So that time again we need to take the CFD based element type, and then when you are going for the thermal, yes, we need to take the thermal based element types. So here we are going to discretize the domain into smaller part. So here what we are saying that, so we are taking one dimensional heat pin fins. Here we are saying that the node, whatever the nodes are, two noded. So two node pin fins are here. So described as the given fin using a suitable element. So let the given fin is discretized into two noted one dimensional element having a T1 and T2 at node 1 and node 2 respectively as shown in the figure. And you can see that L be the length of the given element. So we are going to discretize the domain, and we are naming it in terms of two noded element. So you can see here node number 1 and node number 2. So we are going to name this as a temperature T1 and temperature T2. So remember that it is moving in x direction, and we are making here that one source point here. From this source point, how the variations are occurring, right? So here you can see that the x1 is a length. So from the one point that we are making here, from here to the T1, that is node 1. So x1 is there, and then node 2, that is T2. So here x2. So x2 minus x1 will give the LE. That is the elemental length. So already we discussed this with respect to the bar element, with respect to the structural problem. And then next step will be, so remember that we are describing with respect to the steps here. So first step is describe the given domain using a suitable element type, and then next will be the assume, and the second step will be the assume a linear variation temperature model. So as we discussed in the bar problem, so there we again we have taken the linear variation model. right? So with respect to the structural, now we are going to take this with respect to the temperature model. So here we are discussing that temperature of the element with respect to x direction. So we are making the only one directional, it is one dimensional. If we put a comma and y, then it will be two dimensional problem, right? So we are making here that the TE of x is equal to a naught plus a1 into x. So that is in terms of that we here it is representing in terms of shape function. So that we'll see in the later part. So we'll concentrate at this box here. So TE, that is the temperature of element with respect to x direction. So a naught plus a1x. So that is the first equation, where a naught and a1 are generalized coordinates to be determined from the boundary conditions. Again, boundary conditions are very important here. So remember that here. So with respect to this particular figure, we are doing it. So the boundary conditions will be right. So see here, when x is equal to x1, so when x is equal to x1, right? So that is t is equal to t1, it will be. So as we have taken from the structural problem, so when x is equal to x1, t is equal to t1 at node 1. Similarly, when x is equal to x2, t is equal to t2 at node 2. So this two, when we are substituting in the above equation using the boundary condition, substituting and solving, will get a naught and a1. Already we discussed this with respect to the structural problem, right? So next, when we substitute this these values in the above equation, so we are going to get the expression in terms of the temperature variation, that is T is equal to, so that is TE of x, that is in x direction, is equal to t1 x2 minus t2 x1 divided by x2 minus x1. So again plus t2 minus t1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x, right? So this is in the form of this a0 plus a1 x, right? So we filled the value of a0 and a1 here and this equation, and then we got this expression. So you remember here that x2 minus x1 here, x2 minus x1 here, so both looks similar, so or same. So we can see that LE here. So when we do that one, so we can, when we rearrange this one, so we'll get the t1 you know, the values here and t2 values over here. So that is t of x is equal to x2 minus x divided by LE into t1 and plus x minus x1 divided by LE into t2. So this equation number is 2. So or we can write in terms of shape function that already we discussed in the above here. So here you can see that n is equal to x2 minus x divided by LE, that is the first n1, and then the shape function n2 is nothing but n2 is equal to x2 minus x1 divided by LE. So all put together we can write as TE of x is equal to n1 into t1 plus into t2. So this is the shape function for temperature variation. So when it comes to the variation in a structural, that is displacement, that is n1 u1 plus n2 u2. Hope you remember that one. So same here incorporated here. So here we are saying with respect to temperature in x direction, that is n1 t1 plus n2 t2, that is the third equation.